momentarily. An aerial attack, Oregon State and Washington State. Let's send it out to Joe Davis and David Diaz Infante. Guys.
Matt, welcome to ESPNU College Football Primetime, presented by 5-Hour Energy in Pullman, Washington, at a sold-out Martin Stadium. It's Oregon State and Washington State, two teams that are off to good starts here in 2013. And with that Stanford loss earlier today to Utah, Oregon State now sits right in the driver's seat with a chance to get to 3-0 and tie Oregon at the top of the North Division standings. And with that, we say welcome inside our broadcast booth. Two-time Super Bowl champ Dave Diaz Infante, Joe Davis. If you like offense, you're in the right spot. Both these teams throw the ball well. Both these teams struggle to run it. They get to the same place, but they get there totally differently.
In completely different styles. Too. You look at Oregon State, more of a pro-style offense, tight ends and fullbacks, and Washington State, more of a pure spread system, the air raid system that Mike Leach has been famous for.
All right, Oregon State, top receiver, top quarterback in the country, and Brandon Cooks and Sean Mannion.
Yeah, Sean Mannion and Brandon Cooks are the top duo in college football. Sean Mannion, 21 touchdowns, 2 interceptions, playing with a great deal of confidence and excellent decision-making. That's because he knows he could count on number 7 right there. Down the field, he is always open. He plays the ball well in the air, and it's very aggressive. He is the guy to watch.
So the Beavers have the top passer in the country. Washington State has the number 3 passer in Connor Halliday.
Yeah, Connor Halliday, again, from that spread system, is distributing the ball to a variety of different players on the field. 12 players with 10-plus receptions. The ball comes out quickly, and they're going to throw it around the yard as much as anybody. Should be exciting to see what comes out on top.
Should be a lot of fun. Washington State and Oregon State kicking off in a moment. We'll revisit a great day of college football as our night rolls on. Where does the Pac-12 stand nationally? And it's Dad's Weekend here in Pullman. We'll detail some of the festivities, but kickoff is coming up next.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by New Raspberry 5-Hour Energy. Available for a limited time. Get yours now. And in part by Chrysler, imported from Detroit.
Cougar Walk earlier today after the team stayed in Lewiston, Idaho, about 40 minutes down the road last night. It came up a couple of hours before the game for Mike Leach's squad. He's in his second season at Washington State. Former Big 12 Coach of the Year at Texas Tech, owner of a law degree, New York Times best-selling author. Really interesting, fun guy to talk to. And his second season as head coach of the Cougars. And on the other sideline, 60-year-old Mike Riley is the longest tenured head coach in the Pac-12. Took over the program for the second time in 2003. He had coached at Oregon State 97 and 98 before a stint in the NFL.
It is tail. Washington State, you've won the puck. Washington State has won the puck and will receive. Which way do you want to kick? With your back that direction, please.
So Washington State will have the ball to begin. In a series that dates back to 1903. And Matt Schick told you just a moment ago, lately it's been all Oregon State, but really balanced over the years, just a 2-win advantage for the Cougars. So we enter this 98th meeting between a couple of teams off to good starts in this early season Pac-12 North matchup.
Well, you know, Coach Riley, Corvallis is home for him. And he's left, he's come back, and he really is the face of that program, the things he's been able to do there, the football teams he's put together. And this one may very well be on their way to do something special again this year.
So we talked about it a little bit off of the top, but these two teams really similar in the end results. They might get there a little bit differently with Oregon State as a pro-style team and then the air raid of Washington State. But at the end of the day, they're passing for a lot of yards and not doing much on the ground.
Well, they're also scoring a lot of points, and they're winning football games right now. It's interesting. I think Oregon State would like to establish a run. I think Coach Ryan would like to get that run game going. Where on the other side, Mike Leach and Washington State, I don't think they care. You know, the running backs and the bubble screens and all that are part of their running game. What they consider balance is ball distribution. They've done exactly that so far this season.
That's Ricky Galvin back to receive this kick from Oregon State, along with Christoph Williams. Trevor Romain to kick it away for Oregon State. Now we're ready to go from Pullman, Washington. It's Galvin to take a touchback on a kick that was only 2 yards deep. Now Washington State to begin at the 25-yard line. In the second year of Mike Leach's air raid offense, top 10 nationally throwing the ball. With Connor Halliday, the redshirt junior out of Spokane, Washington, who threw for 521 yards last week, the only quarterback in FBS to do so this year, topping 500 yards in a game. So from the 25, first play and first throw, gets rid of it quickly. And gets 7 yards to the 32. That's Ricky Galvin, who's coming off what Coach Leach said was his best game. And Steven Nelson with a stop. Against this Oregon State defense, giving up 30 points a contest, but coming off what they felt was their best game 2 weeks ago against Colorado. Gave up 300 yards in that game, but more than half of it came in the fourth against mostly backups. On second and three, rid of it quickly again to the leading receiver, Gabe Marks, and a first down to the 38. He's Washington State's impact player when they're on offense.
And right on tune was there, Gabe Marks. He is the guy that makes it happen for them offensively on the perimeter. He's a big play receiver. It's going to be up to Steven Nelson and Rashad Reynolds to lock him down, tight coverage, to allow their defensive front to put some pressure on Connor Halliday.
The opening drive for the Cougars, first down at the 32. And the first run play goes to Marcus Mason, who's only averaging about 6 carries a game. Junior out of California gets a couple. Dylan Wynn with a stop, and it's second down.
And Connor Halliday will only hand the ball off just to keep you honest up front. They got big splits up front. They're going to throw it all over when they hand it off to take the defense to catch them a little bit off guard.
Pressure coming on second down. Halliday swings it out to Mason, who led the team in receiving yards last week with 118 in that win over Cal. Steven Nelson pushes him out, and it'll be third down.
And you see Connor Halliday too. Mike Leach talking about his decision making. He knows exactly where to go with the football. You see how quickly the ball is getting out. That means that D-line has no chance to put any pressure on him.
That was one of the things the Beaver staff talked about, trying to make Halliday get rid of it more quickly than he wants. On time and on target, first down to the true freshman River Craycraft. Tyreek Zimmerman pushes him out after a first down. Now Connor Halliday has been a different guy in the 4 wins for Washington State this year than the 2 losses, one against Stanford, one against Auburn.
Yeah, the biggest thing he has to do is take care of the football. Be smart with it, good decisions, and don't force it. Take what the defense is giving you.
Into Oregon State territory, and Mason into the arms of Scott Crichton. Runs hard for a few, and it'll be second down and 7. Opening drive for Washington State. Pressure on second down. Halliday with a deep drop. Has Williams and a first down inside the 25. Don Williams, who's averaging close to 20 yards a reception, gets 18 and a first down.
Well, Oregon State and Mark Banker, defensive coordinator, decided to bring pressure, and Connor Halliday makes him pay for the accurate throw up the seam to his wide receiver.
On first down, catch and throw. This is Bobby Ratliff setting up first down and goal. Had a team high 8 catches last week and has 14 yards on his first touch here.
Watch how quickly Connor Halliday gets rid of the football. He knows exactly where to go with it. And Bobby Ratliff there to make the reception in space and yards after the catch.
The sixth different receiver that Connor Halliday has found in his first six throws. Jeremiah Laufasa, their bigger back into the game. He's got a touchdown every four carries this year. Halliday rolls, looking in the end zone. And trying to turn the corner and get run out of bounds by Ryan Murphy. And it'll be second down and goal. Scott Crichton with the pressure off of the edge, one of the more talented defensive linemen in the Pac-12.
Yeah, Scott Crichton is a guy that has to find a way to get to Connor Halliday. Again, they brought pressure that time. Halliday does a smart thing, does not force the ball in tight man-to-man coverage in the red zone, gains positive yardage and runs out of bounds.
On second down and goal, Halliday pressured, retreating, and throwing low. Was looking for Laufasa out of the backfield. Now third down and goal. A red zone has been an issue for Washington State. Worst in the Pac-12.
And you'll see the pressure coming by the Oregon State defensive line, forcing Connor Halliday to get rid of the football. And the onus is going to be on that offensive line of Washington State. Protect Connor Halliday. He's been beat up. He got beat up against Stanford. Had a gutsy performance last week against Cal. But they've got it to limit the hits that he takes in the pocket.
24 trip into the red zone for Washington State this year. Just 13 touchdowns. Halliday throwing to the goal line. It's incomplete. Was looking for Don Williams. And it'll be fourth down and goal. So the Cougars likely having to settle for a field goal.
And we talked about accuracy with Connor Halliday. You'll see the ball low and outside. That time the receiver got to find a way to make that catch. When you're a throwing football team, this is where these types of teams can struggle, in the red zone where the spaces get condensed.
Andrew Ferney, senior out of Burlington, Washington, who's 8-for-10 this year. On to attempt the 27-yarder. And Washington State has points on its opening possession. And Connor Halliday spreading the ball around just like the Washington State offense is designed to do. It's 3-0 Cougars, and Oregon State on offense for the first time when you come back.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the WatchESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Back at a sold-out Martin Stadium, where they're fired up about the start to this season for their Cougars at 4-2. Already more wins than year one of the Mike Leach era. Trying to reach five wins for the first time since 07, and in search eventually of their first bowl trip in a decade. This will be Victor Bolden taking a touchback, and Oregon State to begin at the 25-yard line. So we saw that air raid style from Washington State. Now we'll see pro style from Oregon State. Top 20 in the country, averaging more than 40 points a game. Behind Sean Mannion, who's the nation's leading passer, more than 2,000 yards, 21 touchdowns, and coming off his school record performance, threw for 6 TDs in the win against Colorado 2 weeks ago.
Yeah, what really impressed me on him about me on tape was his pocket presence. He slides and shifts in the pocket, knows where to go with the football, and he will hang in there to make the throw down the field.
It starts with play action, eyes downfield, and will come underneath with a ball that's batted in the air and incomplete. Was looking for his fullback, Tyler Anderson. Pressure from Cache Palacio, and it's second and 10.
This Washington State defense, they are aggressive. They're going to attack you on every different level, give you multiple looks. It'll be interesting to see how Oregon State deals with it, especially up front with their offensive line.
You know, Washington State aggressive, ball hawking unit, lead of the Pac-12 in takeaways. Second and 10. Straight drop, quick throw. Brandon Cooks is shut down by DeMonte Horton, and that's a matchup to look for today.
That's right. It's going to be up to DeMonte Horton and Deion Buchanan again to try to contain Brandon Cooks, the number one playmaking receiver out there. Tackling his space against him is critical. Put your hands on him, not letting him get over the top of the safeties in the secondary.
And Horton got his first possession following Cooks around the field. He split out to the top of your screen for 3rd and 6. The twist is picked up, giving Mannion time to deliver a strike and a first down. Went the opposite way of Cooks this time and found his second leading receiver, Richard Mullaney, for a gain of 13 and a first down.
We talked about Sean Mannion. Watch him stand in the pocket and throw a strike down the middle of the field. Tight coverage, tight window. Look at the ball placement. Look at the velocity. And Richard Mullaney is a guy that makes catches for first downs and touchdowns. He's productive, great hands.
20 of his 26 grabs this year gone for a first down. First carry for Storm Woods, who's got 7 yards before Daryl Monroe makes the stop. Woods seeing his first action in 3 weeks. He missed the last 2 games with a concussion, but a good sign there with those 8 yards on the first run play.
Yeah, that is encouraging. They want to get the run game going. They're built for it, and their offensive line is healthier now. The bye week helped them. Getting Woods back should help, too. That's great to see them have success running the football on first down.
2nd and 3 and back to the run. First down for Woods, close to the 45. You mentioned the offensive line being banged up, close to full strength for the first time right now.
And you'll see again, this time they're going to send Brandon Cooks in motion around, faking the reverse to him and just handing the ball off to Woods right up the middle. Nice job of the offensive line creating the seams up inside.
This is the 5th different starting lineup up front for Oregon State in 6 games. Play action on 1st and 10. Mannion steps up. Confident throw is broken up. Out of the secondary, Taylor Taliulu, the sophomore out of Hawaii, with a great defensive play. 2nd down and 10.
Taliulu is a guy that's been coming on strong for them. He's athletic, he's big, and he is getting better with every week. That time making a great break on the football.
Full-time starting role for the first time for him. A guy that stood out to Oregon State staff on film for his toughness. D-tackle got back. And Mannion hands it off. And Storm Woods is cut down after a yard. Well, the draw game was a big part of what they did last year, really the last few years, but they've not been able to get it going this year.
They haven't been able to get any sort of running game going, you know, them and Washington State both at the same time. It's interesting, though, because they've got to try and get it going because so much of what they do is based off play action. 2 tight end sets, a fullback, and that just gives them an opportunity to get the ball down the field to Brandon Cooks even more.
Cooks, the lone receiver to the near side for 3rd and 9. Mannion with time steps into his throw, and Cooks can't hang on. There's a flag down at the line of scrimmage. Coverage from Daquan Brown, the true freshman, making only his 2nd start.
Prior to the snap, false start on the offense, number 77. That's a 5-yard penalty, 3rd down.
And if you're Oregon State, you're okay with that because the play technically doesn't happen. And you get another shot at 3rd down.
Another opportunity.
So Mike Riley's squad, after that loss to Stanford earlier today, or loss by Stanford earlier today at Utah, trying to stay perfect and at the top of the Pac-12 North. Mannion off his back foot over the head of Cooks. The timing route was thrown off by the pressure from Xavier Cooper. And Washington State forces a punt on Oregon State's first possession.
And you'll see Xavier Cooper again just winning the 1-on-1 on the top of your screen right there. Number 96. And hitting Mannion and putting pressure on him and forcing the inaccuracy of the delivery of the ball.
First punt for Keith Kostel. Leon Brooks waiting back at the 10. And Woods blocked. Washington State gets a piece. And the Cougars will have great field position as it travels only 13 yards. Theron West got his hand on it. Those special teams have been a strength for Oregon State, but it's Washington State scheming it up to get to Costell and set up great field position for the offense.
There's Halliday. Over the middle, wide open. Vince Bailey makes the catch. Midfield breaks the tackle. It's a race. And into the end zone for the touchdown. Halliday dumps it over to Mason, who's got the catch and has a blocker. One man to beat at the 15, the 10. Here's Halliday. Wants that one-on-one coverage up the left sideline, and it is caught! Touchdown, Washington State!
Only 500-yard performance by quarterback this season. Threw for 521 and fell 10 short of his school record in that win against Cal. It starts with a quick throw into the flats for Gabe Marks. Second leading receiver in the Pac-12, now with 43 catches this season. He gets 9, second and 1.
It was Bobby Ratliff out in front of him, blocking on the perimeter while wide receivers in this offense is paramount. You've got to do your share of that. Creates big plays in space for guys like Gabe Marks. You know, you look back at that Cal game, and more impressive about this Washington State team was only one sack in 67 attempts. That offensive line stepped up and did a great job.
That's a group that gave up 57 sacks last year, most nationally, just 10 this year. Here's Ricky Galvin, catch and throw, first down into Oregon State territory. Tripped up by Jabril Johnson, but boy, you talk about getting rid of the ball in a hurry.
You'll see Ricky Galvin right here, he's number 5, right there, the number 3 receiver there, trips to one side, he's going to be wide open, uncovered, just a quick throw and reaction by Connor Halliday.
Caldwell motions out, the floated for Williams, who can't catch up, had a step on Rashawn Reynolds, and it's second down and 10. A quick passing game, an extension of the run game, and this air raid offense really serves as the run game.
Yeah, absolutely. It's a controlled passing game. And if you know where to go with the football and you understand the leverage of the defense, and right now Connor Halliday has it going. He's in a rhythm.
Oregon State bringing heat. They bring 6. And Bartoloni was shut down as the ball got there by Murphy. And it'll be 3rd down and 10. We've broken down some of the storylines for you. Narrow it down even further. Is the 3 things you think will go a long ways in deciding this game?
Yeah, absolutely. 1, turnovers. If Connor Halliday can take care of the football, good things are going to happen for Washington State. Explosive plays on both sides of the ball. They've got to create them and limit them defensively. And then Mannion to Cooks, that's the number 1 duo in the country. If Washington State can keep that under control like they've started to, boy, I tell you what, they're heading the right direction.
Only 3 rush on 3rd down and 10 against 8-man coverage. Tried to sneak one into Marks, but off his fingertips. And it's 4th down. Coverage from Steven Nelson and Ryan Murphy. The punt team not coming out just yet. With the ball at the 43-yard line, kind of that in-between territory.
Yeah, do you want to play field position or you want to take a chance? And I think they're going to try and pin him back. Smart decision.
And it's Brandon Cooks that'll go back to receive this punt from Mike Bowling. This is short punt, 28 yards, and Oregon State to begin at the 15-yard line. Washington State forced a punt in the first possession for the Beavers. We'll see what they have in store for possession 2 after this. Ball primetime presented by 5-Hour Energy at Martin Stadium in Pullman, Washington. Oregon State is set for its 2nd possession of the game. Drove the ball down the field and then stalled on its opening possession. Mannion with a straight drop. Strong arm throw to the sideline for Cooks, but it's too tall. Horton with the coverage. And 2nd down and 10.
And that one just got away from Sean Mannion. Again, one-on-one coverage outside to Cooks. Came out in a 2 tight end set and saw the matchup. Ball just got away from him.
Nation's leading passer, taking care of the ball for the first time. He came into the year with 31 touchdowns, 31 picks in his career, but so far this year, a 21-2 ratio. Straight drop on second down, looking for his tight end, Connor Hamlet, who makes a tremendous catch for 6 yards to the 21. Darryl Monroe with the coverage and the tackle.
Tight ends are such a big part of the offense. You'll see him right there again. He's going to release off the line of scrimmage and watch an accurate throw away from the defender. And what a catch right there by Hamlin. One-handed. That's how to help your quarterback out. Let's get him in a rhythm, get some things going, make a manageable third down.
Third and four. Mannion looking in Cook's direction, floating it out of the backfield for Storm Woods, who steps out of an ankle tackle and has a first down across the 40. Boy, they had Cook's going inside and then took Woods out of the backfield to replace him for 24 yards.
Yeah, they call him a man-to-man coverage, and you'll see Woods right here. He's going to go this way with picks going inside. He's one-on-one. He's got the defender leveraged right away, and what a touch throw by Mannion.
The running backs for Oregon State talking about the lack of running game that they've had. The running backs have more yards receiving than they do rushing on the season. For Storm Woods, that holds true early on in this game. Not what you'd expect out of a pro-style offense, but whatever works. Oregon State takes a timeout. Inside of 5 minutes left in this first quarter.
On the Western.
He admitted that they need more of a ground game and said that he intended to call more runs. But the fact is, when you got Sean Mannion and Brandon Cooks, sometimes that's just what works best. On first down, they fake the jet sweep. Mannion is under pressure, able to get rid of it to the sideline for Woods. 4 yards, second down and six. Pressure from Ioane Nauta, and a good job by Mannion to use all arm to get that ball to the sideline.
Well, that's one of the things that really impressed me about him, is his pocket presence. Boy, he's got soft focus in the pocket, hard focus down the field. Eyes never on the rushers, on the receivers. Slides, hitches, and you see the strength shaking off that sack and making a completion.
Second down, throwing the bubble screen. Here's Brandon Cooks, cut down by Cyrus Cohen. And he'll set up a third down and short for Oregon State.
And you'll see Cooks right there. They're going to stack the receivers, one in front of them, just a little bubble out to him. And he's going to find a way to pick up yardage. He's an exciting player. That's one thing that Washington State has to do, is tackle in space. When they have an opportunity to wrap his arms around him, boy, you've got to take him down.
Third and short. And Mannion works out of the gun. The twist is picked up. Wide open man is Kevin Cummings for a first down to the 39. Nobody at the second level in the box. And Cummings ran right there for the first down.
And you'll see Cummings too. There's a tight end's going to clear, and he's going to come underneath them and just get enough for the first down. He's going to have leverage on the defender. You'll see him break inside. There he is, wide open for the first down. Nice job of setting up that route. Nice decision by Sean Mannion, knowing where the sticks were and picking up the first down.
From the 39, fakes to Woods and rolls. He's looking downfield, taking a shot. A strike for a first down inside the 20. Richard Mullaney with his second catch. Tackle made by Deon Buchanan at a gain of 23.
You'll see again, a little play action fake. He's going to roll right. Look, they're trying to take a shot down the field. It's not there. He's going to hit him over the middle on the crossing route. Again, nice catch by Mullaney. Another first down for him.
It's a screen. It's a tight end, Caleb Smith, surging inside the 10. Donna Pritchard with a stop, but a good call for the defense that Washington State had on, bringing pressure.
That's right. Your tight end could be your best friend when a team is blitzing. A nice job by Caleb Smith of uncovering underneath the coverage. Saw the pressure. He's hot. He was open.
Second down and two. Storm Woods. Good surge this time to set up first down and goal. That offensive line that entered camp is a strain, but has been banged up and has had to shuffle things around, finally close to full strength.
We'll get Grant Anger back at right guard. Again, he'd been out for the last three games. He's a captain, a veteran guy in there, and allows Siumalu to move back to center, his original position. And Harlow steps up at right tackle. So this group had a week to work together. They're back in sync. It's starting to show itself here.
Here comes Cooks in motion. Instead, Woods gets drilled at the line of scrimmage. Deion Buchanan, the Pac-12's third leading tackler, stops him for a loss, and it's second and goal.
And again, Washington State bringing pressure, and you're seeing Buchanan coming off inside. This rusher comes in. Here comes Buchanan, unblocked in the backfield, and he doesn't miss the layup. Watch the hit he lays on the running back. That's attacking from the secondary.
Guy that added close to 20 pounds since last year. Violent hitter, second and goal, and an empty set. With pressure in his face, it's Cooks inside the five. Excellent job to get rid of it with the pressure from Xavier Cooper. DeMonte Horton with a stop and third down and goal.
And you'll see Cooks again stutter step up and then clear underneath on the shallow crossing route. Knows he's going to take a hit, covers up. That shows his toughness. He's not just a guy that plays on the perimeter. He makes tough catches over the middle. He's physical and he's mentally tough.
And the timeout taken.
Timeout. Washington State, number one. 30 seconds.
First Washington State timeout of the half. And it's the most thorough college football show on television with in-depth analysis, discussion of the standings, potential impact of upcoming games, and interviews of college football coaches and players. You don't want to go anywhere else. BCS Countdown presented by Allstate Sunday, 8:30 on ESPN, and then at 9 on ESPNU. Both shows are also live on Watch ESPN. They got your full playbook here at third down and three as far as red zone offense goes, and they've got really good tight ends.
Yeah, tight ends are big down here in tight spaces, and they're tight ends. They're 6 foot six, 6 foot seven, Hamlet and Smith. They're big targets. It's a great time to use them right now. We'll see if they get a little play action going too.
There's Caleb Smith, who's got a catch on this drive. There's Connor Hamlet, 6'7", 265.
Here's the two tight ends right here, lined up next to each other.
Play action, looking for the tight ends. Has time, looking for Smith, but it's too tall, and it's fourth down. Deion Buchanan in coverage, forcing a field goal attempt. We're at 6'6", 260, running along the backside of that end zone. And Mannion put it in a spot where only Smith could have caught it.
Looks like Mannion wanted Hamlet too in the flat, but he was limping through his route. I don't know what happened coming out of his break. Be interesting to see if he's all right. Had to try and get that ball into Smith.
Chip shot for Romaine, basically an extra point to tie the game at three. So Oregon State marches down and headed first down and goal, but Washington State able to slam the door and force the field goal. Well, celebrating its ninth year, sponsoring the Good Hands Field Goal Nets, Allstate makes contributions to participating universities' general scholarship funds for each field goal and extra point kicked. To date, Allstate has contributed more than $3 million in scholarship monies. Oregon State band making the trip from Corvallis. This matchup between two teams off to good starts. Early season Pac-12 North matchup.
Well, both teams have gotten the ball down the red zone, but they haven't been able to put it in the end zone. gotten close, had to settle for field goals.
And Sean Mannion, who injured his knee against Mike Leach's team last year, missed a couple of games. That's what opened the door for Cody Vaz. And what would turn into a controversy, Vaz wound up playing most of the bowl game. And Mike Riley didn't announce a starter until towards the end of fall camp. And Mannion will tell you that it was a conversation he had with Danny Langsdorf, the offensive coordinator, right after they made that decision public. Langsdorf went in and said, listen, you're our guy. There is no controversy anymore. The confidence derived from that's been big for him.
Well, that's big when a quarterback knows he doesn't have to look over his shoulder. He can look forward and how he's going to lead this football team and execute this offense.
So Washington State ready to come back out for its third drive. Connor Halliday started 6 for 6, since then 2 of 7. Two of the nation's top three passers going head to head tonight. Drive to begin at the 25 for the Cougars. And trying to set up the screen, this is T'Andre Caldwell. And a great job to fight off of the block by DJ Alexander. The guy Mike Riley said would be key tonight, covering in space and pressure in the quarterback from his strong side linebacker spot. Got a couple, only to be second down and 7, likely to begin the second quarter.
Well, DJ Alexander fought off the blocker and made that tackle. That's what you have to do. The screen game is huge for Washington State. And when you may have that kind of effort outside to make that tackle in space, that's exactly what you need defensively.
So these two high-powered offenses settle for just 3 during the first quarter. Oregon State and Washington State onto the second, locked at 3.
ESPNU College Football Primetime, brought to you by Dr. Pepper, always one of a kind, and the all-new line of Gator utility vehicles. Nothing runs like a deer.
It's the only facility in the world to house adult grizzlies for research. The captive bear facility currently has 6 indoor dens with outdoor runs, 2-plus-acre exercise yard. Yeah, the campus of Washington State as Connor Halliday gets ready to go back to work. He's gotten rid of the ball quickly, and that's all the difference for him in this offense.
Yeah, that's big in terms of this offense. Again, getting the ball out quickly, and it has to do with his ability to know where to go with the ball, pre-snap and post-snap. You see an instance of that right there, getting the ball off, avoiding the hit. When he's forced to hang on to a tight coverage, you see what happens. There's a defensive end. He takes a hit, fumble. That's the difference. How quickly you get the ball off in this offense.
Now, as a reference point, and they don't do this for college football, but you go to the NFL and look, the best in the NFL was Tom Brady. Got rid of it on an average 2.47 seconds. Quarter begins with a 2nd down and 7. Run play, and Marcus Mason with a 1st down across the 40. All he has 144 yards on the season coming in. Bust this one for 15.
You see Marcus Mason again, that offensive line doing their job. He's just going to go around the corner right there. They seal the edge. You look, it catches the defense by surprise. And that's really what how their run game works here. They're going to sneak it through the seams and cracks of that defensive line.
Extra man comes on 1st down. The swing to Mason, who took one of these 68 yards for a touchdown last week. Steven Nelson waiting on this one, drops him down after 2. It'll be 2nd down and 8.
And you see the tempo right now for Washington State. Connor Halliday getting the plays, lining up. Again, spreading the ball. They force you to defend the whole field, horizontally and vertically.
And that is Mike Leach's idea of balance versus 50-50 run pass. Halliday throws high, but Christoph Williams pulls it down and runs for a 1st down. The junior out of Antioch, California, having by far his best season, has 13 and a 1st down for the Cougars.
And again, they're just running crossing routes underneath. And Christoph knows exactly where to go with the ball. Christoph Williams, he's open underneath, and Connor Halliday just puts it right on him.
Already career highs in receptions and yards for the redshirt junior. who sets up a first down at the 42. Here's a screen for Gabe Marks, and Oregon State read it well. Nelson slowed him up, and then he was dropped down by Sean Martin, who's in the game as the nickel for Oregon State, and it'll be second down.
And you'll see Marks outside. He's going to make the catch. Looks like he has a little bit of room. But another great job of the secondary. Steven Nelson fighting off the blocks of the wide receivers. And then again, it's number six, Sean Martin, coming in and cleaning it up.
Those two guys have battled for a starting corner spot opposite Rashad Reynolds. Nelson winning the job, but Martin seeing time in the nickel this week. Mason downhill, ran into the arms of a defender, but bounced away from Jabril Johnson to get a yard. Scott Crichton wound up making the tackle, and it's third down and nine.
And Jabril Johnson came from his linebacker position. He read that right away and attacked downhill. He's got to finish it by wrapping up a little bit, but boy, he brought a little heat.
Been an important piece to this defense with the injuries they've had at linebacker. He's starting for Michael Doctor, team captain, at that weak side backer spot.
Yeah, he moved from the Sam to the Will. He's done a great job.
Pressure out of the secondary, trying to take advantage for Williams, who had beaten Reynolds. And it had turned into a one-on-one with a safety blitzing, but it's too far and it's fourth down.
You're going to see Ryan Murphy here for the top of your screen. He's going to disguise his blitz coming there, no one there to pick it up, and he lays a lick on Connor Halliday. That one he felt, and he'll feel tomorrow for sure.
And Halliday knocked out of the Stanford game with a rib injury. It's a kid that last year missed time with a lacerated kidney. They're going to go for it on fourth down and eight. Pressure picked up. Halliday finds a window and finds Don Williams for a first down at the 20. They needed eight. They got 23 to move the chains.
And you see Don Williams again. Outside, he's going to break over the middle, and there he is, right in the window. Nice, accurate throw on time by Connor Halliday.
Washington State now 9 of 13 on fourth down this year.
We'll see if Oregon State decides to pressure here in the red zone.
Halliday making a change at the line. They bring just four. Halliday steps into his throw as Gabe Marks for a solid first down gain. Had a step on Steven Nelson on that slant. He picked up his fifth tackle of the day, second down and five.
And Gabe Marks again, and Connor Halliday hooking up. Accurate throw, tight coverage by the defense of Oregon State. There's no defense for the perfect throw.
Oregon State bringing pressure, throwing the fade, end zone, incomplete, looking for Vince Maley. Four of his 11 catches on the season have been touchdowns, nearly got another.
Oregon State brings pressure. There's Maley. He's open. What a throw by Connor Halliday. Just can't stay in bounds. Body control's got to take over. The ball was there, up in the air. Feet are clearly out of bounds.
That's a guy really coming on. Mike Leach excited about him. One of the nation's most highly touted JUCO transfers. A senior in his first and only season at Washington State. On third down, Halliday gets rid of it quickly. First down and goal. Christoph Williams with his second catch of the drive. Running a speed out against Nelson.
Connor Halliday knew exactly go with the football. Again, he saw the one-on-one matchup. A great route again by Christoph Williams. Accurate throw by Halliday.
The reaction from Mike Riley, a new third down would be big.
Well, that's part of it. When you know where to go with the football, he saw the matchup, he saw the leverage on the defender. The out was there, accurate throw, pitch and catch.
Second trip into the red zone for Washington State. Came away with a field goal the first time. Here's Mason downhill and into the end zone for the touchdown. First rushing touchdown of the season for the junior. Washington State jumps in front.
The come out in a two-back set. Mason's going to take the handoff. It's one-on-one, the safety that's late at the line of scrimmage. He wins that battle for the touchdown.
Extra point from Andrew Fernie. Out of the hole to the talented backup quarterback, Austin Apodaca. And it's 10-3 Washington State. Not just his first rushing touchdown of the season, but his first since 2011. And Connor Halliday spreading the ball around once again. Found five different receivers on that touchdown drive that went 75 yards to put the Cougars out in front. ...75-yard scoring drive for Washington State. The Cougars trying to reach five wins for the first time since 07. Have the first touchdown of the night. The kickoff from Mike Bolin. To be taken a few yards deep by Victor Bolin. He'll take a knee. Well, tomorrow, ESPNU's coverage of women's college volleyball continues with action out of the American when the Knights take on the Cardinals. Women's college volleyball with Central Florida and Louisville. Tomorrow at 1 o'clock on ESPNU and live on Watch ESPN. It'll be a good football game the following weekend, too. UCF and Louisville.
Absolutely.
So here comes Sean Mannion. Good success for him in this Oregon State offense. Drove it down and then stalled in Washington State territory on their first possession and then settled for a field goal possession number two. Washington State brings heat on first down. Mannion to the middle of the field for Mullaney. And a first down to the 43. Made the cut inside of the freshman Daquan Brown to get a gain of 18.
You're going to see this right here. It's an I formation. Watch these linebackers come up with the play action. Knows he's got one-on-one coverage, and Mullaney's right there. Gets inside the defensive back completion.
Guy that had a few drops against Colorado, normally really sure-handed. We're off to a good start in this one. Here's Storm Woods getting tripped up at the line of scrimmage and getting three. I beg your pardon, that's Teron Ward into the game at running back. With his first touch, a guy that started the last two games with Storm Woods out. And Coach Riley talks ravenly about the guy. That he's one of the best football players overall on the team. There's a lot on special teams for him, too.
He's a good all-around back. Can run with it, can block. He's a good receiver out of the backfield. Everything you're looking for.
On second and eight, off play action. Mannion zips one. Mullaney once again hangs on for a first down. Taylor Taliulu over the stop on a pickup of 23.
Sean Mannion just stands in the pocket, tall and unafraid, to deliver a strike over the middle. He had to hang again because he knew it was going to cover. The pocket is collapsing, but watch him just stare down the field, unfazed by the pressure. And what? He puts that ball where his receiver can make it. A nice job by Mullaney of protecting the ball with his body from the defensive back.
Looking to throw again out of a collapsing pocket. Cooks tried to go around Horton, but couldn't grab it. And it's second down. That would not have been the first time we'd seen Brandon Cooks make that catch had he pulled it in.
Yeah, the ball was just a little bit low. He couldn't make a play through the defensive back. Close to being an interference call right there. But that shows you the confidence that Mannion has in his big-time receiver, Cooks.
Mike Riley saying, four different pieces different about Sean Mannion this year. Two tangibles, two intangibles. For the junior out of Pleasanton, Oregon. You got accuracy, decision making, and then knowledge and confidence. On the sweep players, Victor Bolden, true freshman, getting a first down inside the 20. Bolden out of Rancho Cucamonga, California. Really explosive kid. They're excited about getting more involved.
And you see again the play fake to Storm Woods, and then Bolden just comes around. You see the speed that he possesses and why they try to get him the ball on that type of action. He gets a handoff running full speed.
First down from the 19, and the bubble screen to Cooks, too far out in front of it. We were talking about Sean Mannion and what's changed for him. This is what Mike Riley tried to put his finger on as far as the difference junior year Sean Mannion versus first two.
Well, you look at the action and decision making. That's 21 touchdowns and 2 interceptions. That's what it tells you. The intangibles, the knowledge of confidence, the system, where to go with the football, and the confidence being named starter and know that your coaches have your back.
And he's going to take a timeout here. And we will step aside with him, trying to even this game up. Washington State with a touchdown lead midway through the second quarter. Oregon State has the nation's top passer and top receiver statistically, and they combine to form one of the nation's top combos. Of course, Johnny Manziel, Mike Evans, pretty good combo as well. They got a good one going on right now down at Ole Miss, trying to hold on to a touchdown lead in the fourth quarter. And then at Fresno State, Derek Carr putting up eye-popping numbers with the help of Devontae Adams, who's got the same number of receptions as Brandon Cooks, but about 300 fewer yards coming into this game tonight.
That is pretty good company right there.
We're ready for a second down play with Oregon State trying to even the issue here in this big Pac-12 North early season matchup. Man, in all kinds of time. Short side and almost intercepted. Boy, Cooks turned into the defender on Daquan Brown. Had he gotten that, he was gone the other way.
Sometimes a quarterback's best friend is your wide receiver when he has to become a defender. And you're going to see Brandon Cooks do just that as Daquan Brown broke on the football.
Brown, a true freshman, making only his second start. He shut down Marquise Lee of USC in his first start. Third and 10. Pressure picked up. Mannion fires. Has Cooks. First down and goal for Oregon State. Yards in the fourth catch of the day for Cooks. The junior out of Stockton, California, setting up a first and goal for the Beavers.
A great job of Brandon Cooks coming back for the football as Mannion was under duress and had to throw that ball off his back leg.
That's all arm. He's got such a strong arm.
And he can make every throw. It throws a great deep ball. He can put it thin and on a rope over the middle and in the seams.
Oregon State, one of the top 20 red zone teams in the country. On the draw, Teron Ward, but that defense collapsing. Got a yard or two. Darryl Monroe makes the tackle and second down and goal. Already the sixth tackle for Monroe, a guy you really liked watching film on Washington State.
Yeah, he was fast and violent, number 13 for Washington State, and he closed. He saw that draw, looked like there was a crease, and he just attacked the line of scrimmage in Storm Woods.
Redshirt sophomore out of Orlando, Florida, who started all 19 games since arriving. Out of the Medicine all Pac-12 as a freshman last year. On second and goal, Mannion rolls, has Ward in the flats, looking to the end zone. It's caught. Touchdown. Connor Hamlet, his tight end with his fourth touchdown reception of the season. And Oregon State an extra point from tying this game.
You want to talk about confidence in your arm as a quarterback and knowing you got a big target in Connor Hamlet, 6'7". And you're going to see Mannion again. He's going to roll out to his right. He's going to have to extend the play because nothing uncovers until late. And he's going to see your big tight end work the back of the end zone on the right side there. And he puts that ball where only his guy can get it.
Romaine ties the game with the extra point. Yeah, 6'7", 265, a guy they think has serious NFL potential.
And he just snagged that ball right out of the air.
Not a bad target to have going across the back of the end zone. And the big guy reaches over the 5'11 Brown for a touchdown and a tie game.
Miami versus number 21 Florida State, Wednesday at 8 on ESPNU.
Oregon State trying to get its fifth consecutive win, trying to stay perfect in Pac-12 play. They'd be tied with Oregon at the top of the Pac-12 North if they could come away with a win. They've tied the game at 10 with a Hamlet touchdown from Sean Mannion. A short kick to be taken by Ricky Galvin. Galvin blocks in front and a seam to bring it back to the 34. Solid return of 23 yards for Ricky Galvin and good field position for the Cougars. Well, it's the most thorough college football show on television with in-depth analysis, discussion of the standings, potential impact of upcoming games, and interviews across the country. You won't want to go anywhere else. BCS Countdown presented by Allstate Sunday at 8:30 on ESPN and then at 9 on ESPNU at both those shows. As always, on Watch ESPN. Washington State back to work from the 35 with Mason on first down. And Washington State, the second worst rushing offense in the country, having some success on the ground in this first half.
You'll see DJ Alexander, he's going to blitz right over here, and he's going to miss making that tackle, and that's going to allow Mason to hit up the crease. Unblocked, Mason avoids him. Positive yardage for Washington State.
Ground game much improved from last year when they were the worst team nationally, but still only UConn averages more yards per game or less yards per game running the football. Jeremiah Laufaso with the first down, running hard into Oregon State territory for 9 yards. Redshirt sophomore out of Kirkland, Washington, who averages a touchdown every 4 touches.
Laufaso gives them a little bit of a power runner inside. You see him just carrying a couple tacklers. Boy, that production running the football is really going to help Washington State.
You see it there, two of the top 10 passing offenses, two of the bottom 3 rushing offenses nationally. Fresh set of downs from the 47. Pressure coming out of the secondary. And on the slant, too low for Vince Maley, who's been targeted twice, but 2 incompletions in second down and 10.
Oregon State trying to tighten up their coverage, playing close to the line of scrimmage and bringing pressure. Force a quick throw.
Connor Halliday, 15 to 23 today. The buck 36 through the air. And has it second down and 10. Only a 3-man rush, so Halliday with time and with a window for Galvin. 13 yards, first down to the 34. The converted running back gets the first down, and then a flag comes out at the end of the play. And Galvin with a look on his face like, really? I think that would lead you to assume that it's on him. Especially with the lack of reaction from the Washington State bench where that came from.
Yeah, it's really a game of cat and mouse right now between defensive coordinator Mark Banker.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct on number 5 on the offense. That's a 15-yard penalty. First down.
So they still get the first down. It comes after the play.
And you'll see Ricky Galvin again. They're dropping 8, trying to tighten up the coverage, but Halliday knows exactly where to go with the football. And there's Galvin, a young guy getting excited. Again, the redshirt junior should know better. Boy, that's just unnecessary. That will get Mike Leach's attention.
First penalty of the day on Washington State. Here's River Craycraft, true freshman, with a flag down, likely holding Steven Nelson with the tackle.
Yeah, holding on the offense, number 77. That's a 10-yard penalty. First down.
Right tackle John Fullington, who's making a team best 37th career start today.
Giving just an extra tug of the jersey there on the edge. Officials are going to see that.
So this was going to be before the personal foul penalty. It was going to be first down inside the 35. They've lost 25 yards in penalty yards on these last 2 plays. Now have it at their own 42 with the first down and 20.
It's a place where Connor Halliday has to take care of the football.
8 in coverage, tight windows underneath. Mason couldn't hang on. Washington State, which really had things rolling after that completion to Galvin. Quickly going downhill on this possession.
Really unforced errors, you know. Unsportsmanlike conduct, a holding penalty.
Three down linemen again for second and 20. And eight in coverage once more for Oregon State. Galvin quickly back in the game after that unsportsmanlike conduct. He gets a chunk of it to make it third down and still 15 yards. Steven Nelson with the tackle.
Oregon State willing to give him that throw and rally to make the tackle.
Nelson had been sharing time with Sean Martin at that corner spot, but four interceptions, which is second in the country, helping him earn that job outright. Martin seeing time mostly out of the nickel tonight. On third down and 15, they rush five. Christoph Williams down the seam, but the throw too far, and it's fourth down. Steven Nelson with the coverage. Yeah, the punt team will have to come out for Washington State.
That's Connor Halliday taking a shot down the field. Just overthrows Christoph Williams.
So Mike Leach's team had driven the ball down to the 33-yard line. And with the penalties, it's all the way back at the 47. They shift strengths of the formation. And a flag down. Brandon Cook signals for a fair catch and he'll make it at the 22. Our head referee, Jack Folliard, to tell us what the flag's for. Boy, it really been a clean game until this drive.
Illegal formation on the offense. Five players in the backfield. That 5-yard penalty will be added to the end of the play. First down.
Washington State didn't have a single penalty over the first 25 minutes of this game, but three on that drive. And Oregon State takes over in a tie game when you come back.
I'm Matt Schick. Coming up at halftime, it is Shake Up Saturday today in college football with plenty of ranked teams falling by the wayside, including in Salt Lake City. We'll show you how Utah shook up the Pac-12 and national title race. We'll take you around the Pac-12 as well. See you at halftime.
All right, Matt, looking forward to it. First down for Oregon State. And Mannion rolls out off play action, but his eyes downfield will float it out of bounds. Good coverage from Horton and Buchanan, and it'll be second down and 10. That loss that he mentioned for Stanford at Utah, tough place to play. But now Oregon State sits in a spot where with a win, they're tied at the top of the North with Oregon.
And with Oregon, and again, that's familiar territory. Shocking loss, Stanford on the road. Rice-Eccles Stadium, it is loud and crazy there. What Utah's able to do is put that Stanford defense in space. It will take advantage of that.
On second down, a deep drop to let those routes develop. Mullaney behind the defense, makes the catch inside the 30. What a first half for Richard Mullaney. 46 yards and an Oregon State first down.
And you'll see Mullaney again down here on the bottom of your screen, and you'll see the confidence that Sean Mannion has to deliver the ball down the field again, hanging in there, throwing it with everything he's got. And what a job of Mullaney to come back for the football, make that catch in traffic. Look at the focus, the concentration.
Five catches in the half for 122 yards for Mullaney. All five of those catches have gone for first downs. And now 23 of his 28 catches on the season, first down grabs. Well, ESPNU's coverage of college basketball media days tips off Wednesday, 1 o'clock with ACC Media Day and the Experts Coaches Roundtable. On Thursday, it'll be the SEC, the American, and the Pac-12. And then the following week, it'll be the Big 12. Don't miss the launch of the college basketball season. Wednesday at 1 o'clock, ACC Media Day, and the Experts Coaches Roundtable right here on ESPNU. Can you believe we're talking college basketball, Dave?
Already.
Jeez. Week 7 of the college football season. Richard Mullaney fully recovered from a shoulder injury that caused him to miss 4 games as a true freshman last year. Having a big night. And in another deep drop, steps up and zings one to Cooks. First down and goal. Boy, the arm strength from the junior Mannion, top level. 22 yards and a first down.
The arm talent is there, the confidence is. And you're going to see him just stand and throw a fastball over the middle to Cooks.
Cooks able to snag it. Fifth catch of the day for the nation's leading receiver. And now has 11 catches of more than 25 yards this season.
Cooks at the top of your screen.
And Smith in motion. Storm Woods with nowhere to go. Penetration before he even got the handoff came from Cyrus Cohen. And then the tackle from Xavier Cooper, the defensive end that the staff thinks has a chance to be special.
And Cyrus Cohen and the safety attack that edge of the offensive set, go unblocked and are in the backfield to stymie that run game of Oregon State.
Third worst nationally running the football. Part of that, the offensive line has been banged up. Part of that has been how much they've relied on Mannion and Cooks. And you don't blame them. Second and goal. Mannion steps up, floating into coverage and intercepted. Picked off by Anthony Carpenter. The senior out of Los Angeles with his first pick of the season. And what a red zone mistake from a guy who reverts back to his 2012 form.
Only his third interception of the year at the worst time in the red zone where you've got to protect the ball. He's going to throw it into double coverage. Again, you see him drop off his other receiver and come underneath the throw. Mannion didn't suspect it. Anthony Carper's there for the INT in the end zone.
So Mannion picked off for just the third time this season, and Washington State back to work with a run play for Teandre Caldwell. Ball comes out and Oregon State has it again. Just like that, Beavers take over at the 35.
Back-to-back turnovers. Teandre Caldwell again fighting for extra yards. You see the football come away from his body. And the Oregon State defense able to recover the ball. It's number 45 coming in there for Oregon State.
Yeah, Dylan Wynn forced it, and then Devin Kell fell on top of it.
You see him rake at the football. He pops it loose. Oregon State recovers. And the momentum shifts once again to Oregon State.
Back-to-back plays with turnovers. And on first down, Mannion trying to make it pay with a screen. And room for Storm Woods. First down and more. Woods is inside the 15. 25 yards on the screen play before Dale Buchanan made the stop.
And what a great job setting up that screen by the offensive line. Blockers out in front, getting guys on the ground. And Storm Woods negotiates his way through traffic for big yardage for Oregon State.
His running backs for the Beavers, more yards receiving than rushing this season. And Oregon State right back where it was before the Mannion interception. Pressure on first down. Mannion pumps back to his second read. Cooks was open, but he misfired, and it's second down.
Again, the pressure was there. You're going to see Cooks delaying a little bit, trying to get back to the corner. He was open, but the defensive line pressure got there.
Defensive line, the strength for this Washington State team. Trying to get to Mannion, who takes such deep drops and makes it tough. over the middle. It's Kevin Cummings for 5 yards. Justin Sagote with a stop. And it'll be third down and goal. We talked about the things to zero in on in this game, the most important things that would decide it. We've seen the Mannion to Cooks connection several times, but lately it's been turnovers, an interception in the end zone. And then in the ensuing play, a fumble from Caldwell gave it right back to Mannion, the Beavers, who have it third and five.
And here's Mannion. There's Cooks right there, isolated on the bottom of your screen.
Safety rolls over. Flag is down. And Mannion throws with a whistle blowing. Pass is incomplete. Nauta with the pressure. And we'll see what this flag is.
I think that play was blown dead.
I thought so, too. And I think about half of the players on the field did. Half kept playing, half stopped.
Offside defense, number 96. The penalty is half the distance to the goal. Repeat, third down.
So it wasn't blown dead. It was indeed a free play. Instead of third down and five, it'll be third down and about two. And they can get a first down here. The marker just inside the 1 yard line. Inside of a minute left in this first half.
See the extra tight ends come on the field for Oregon State. Three in the game.
They run it with Woods, and he powers his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Oregon State. Woods with his third rushing score of the season, and the Beavers have their first lead of the night.
You'll see Storm Woods, they line up two tight ends to the left. They run back to the weak side and watch the offensive line secure the line of scrimmage here and give him just the seam he needs to score. Combination blocks getting to the second level. Storm Woods running with his pad level low.
A guy that missed the last couple of weeks with that concussion. Gives Oregon State its first lead. He said earlier this week that he looked at tonight as the start of a new season with the struggles they had running the football. This is a guy that is a true freshman last year, had 970 yards and 13 touchdowns. But a combination of him missing time, offensive line being banged up, and the reliance on the passing game. But a different year for the sophomore out of Pflugerville, Texas.
And the big thing there is Oregon State's able to capitalize on the short field and the turnover, the fumble by Washington State. Translate that into points.
And now 44 seconds. That's loads of time for Mike Leach in this area.
Yeah, it's a lot more than you think.
Yeah. There's those numbers last year against what he's done this season coming in. But again, he's missed a couple of games. And as Beavers take advantage of the takeaway. Williams and Galvin back to receive the kick from Trevor Romain. And they squib it, taken by one of the up men at the 25. They'll pitch back to Galvin, who's lit up. And Washington State takes control of the 29-yard line. So one timeout. With 40 seconds to work with for Connor Halliday, who started this game red hot, completed his first 6 passes, has cooled off some since. 11 for 21 since that perfect start. Aided coverage on first down. Halliday thrown off of the hands of his intended receiver, Brent Bartoloni. And it'll be second down and 10. Coverage from Tyreek Zimmerman. Really, the 2-minute offense, at least stylistically when you're running the plays, that's what the air raid is.
Absolutely. This is where they live right now. Up tempo. Get the ball out quickly.
Three-man pressure, able to force an errant throw. That was Devin Kell, backup defensive end out of Hawaii. You had Halliday throwing off his back foot, making it third down and 10.
And that's just a 3-man rush.
Right.
Devin Kell just coming off the edge, getting the pressure on Halliday.
Craycraft turned his head right as the throw is coming in his direction and then couldn't get his head back around in time. Three incompletions and a three and out for Washington State. Now you got to worry about Oregon State trying to tack on some points before the break.
Yeah, 26 seconds left. They still have a timeout left as well.
You got the ever dangerous Brandon Cooks going back to receive.
That is right.
Setting up to have some pretty good field position here after the punt from Mike Bolin. Oregon State almost gets to it. Good punt, backing Cooks inside the 20. And it bounces all the way down inside the 5-yard line. Back of a punt from Mike Bolin. Coming at a big spot. 68 yards for Bolin.
With pressure coming at him, he drives that punt, and a mistake right there. Not fielding the ball, but Brandon Cooks.
And so Oregon State will just run the clock here. It was funny talking to Mike Leach about the special teams. He said Bolin has been okay, but he's been inconsistent. Either hits it 20 or he hits it 70. He just about hit it 70 to close this out. Remember earlier he had a 25-yarder. So Mike Leach spot on. The Oregon State with back-to-back touchdowns to go from down a score to up a score heading into the break. Two teams off to good starts, meet it in this important early season Pac-12 North matchup. For now, let's go to Matt Schick and Jay Walker in the studio for the College Football Halftime Report.
Thank you, Joe. Told you before this game, and Joe's been saying it throughout. These teams love to throw, not big fans of running the ball, and that's what we're seeing so far. Oregon State.
Welcome back to ESPNU College Football Primetime, presented by 5-Hour Energy here in Pullman, Washington. And an entertaining first half gives way to the second half with Oregon State in front by a touchdown. Told you all about the nation's leading receiver, Brandon Cooks, in that first half. Five catches for 46 yards.
Well, so far, you'd have to say the Washington State officiate with the attention they're giving Brandon Cooks has been Richard Mullen. He's got 122 yards on five receptions. So he takes something away, you're giving something up. And a nice job of Sean Mannion of getting the football to the guy that's open. You see the ball distribution right there, one screen, and down the field is where they target Cooks.
They wanted to find different ways to get him involved, and as his season rolls on, they're going to have to continue to find more and more ways to get him involved.
You're interested to see if they get him the ball as a ball carrier and rusher in the second half here.
We'll get our first look at Sean Mannion in that offense right away. Washington State won the opening toss and took the ball to begin the game. And so Mike Bolin will kick it away from the 35.
Well, we figure there might be over 100 passes thrown here tonight. So far they're on track with 30 and 29 apiece in the first half.
Yeah, well on track. This will be Victor Bolden, who Mike Riley says is close to busting one. The true freshman out to the 25-yard line. This game featuring two of the nation's top three passers statistically. Manning entered the game as the only guy above 2,000 yards on the season. Halliday not far behind in yards per game. The Halliday started out red hot, 6 for 6, cooled off some. And Sean Mannion pretty consistent throughout that first half.
Yeah, really, just the one mistake, but in a critical part of the field, in the red zone, double coverage in the end zone, instead of throwing the ball away, costs his team points. Those are things that he hasn't done so far this season through his third interception of the year.
So the second half begins from the 25. And Sean Mannion starts it with a bubble screen to Brandon Cooks. Good speed to turn the corner, chopped down by Cohen after 6 yards. And second down and four.
It's a great way to get your playmaker the ball early in the second half. He's a guy that can make things happen. You get some blocking out in front of him. He's that close to breaking one of those.
He's always had good burst. The difference this year for the junior out of Stockton, California, is that he's much stronger, much harder to bring down.
And it shows up on film, too.
Second and four, Storm Woods. But a surge from that Washington State defensive line sets it down. Never could get going. Xavier Cooper leading the way along with Destiny Vial. And it'll be third down at about six coming up.
And you're going to see the line of scrimmage just move, led by Xavier Cooper on this left side right here. He's going to establish the line of scrimmage on the other side of the defensive front. He's going to slant from the end position and make that tackle for a loss.
Oregon State good on third down in the first half. Pressure coming. Manny with time. Into coverage and broken off. Daquan Brown swats it away from Richard Mullaney. And Washington State forces a three and out on Oregon State's opening drive of half number two.
And Daquan Brown, the true freshman, getting it done outside once again. Only his second start of his young career. But he's got big-time playmaking ability. Nice break on the ball there.
Nearly had a pick six in that first half, defending Cooks. As Leon Brooks goes back to receive this punt. From Keith Costell, who had his first one partially blocked, traveled just 13 yards. As Washington State overloaded the middle on that punt block. They bring just one to set up the return for Brooks. He catches on the move inside of the 35 and has room. And Brooks brings it back to Oregon State territory. 26-yard return for Leon Brooks. And so Washington State down a touchdown. They'll have excellent field position for its first possession of the second half. 215 yards in the first half, 156 of those through the air for Connor Halliday.
And so far the special teams unit, Washington State, has showed up here tonight, giving them a short field to play on right now.
They start the second half with a run play to Lau Ufasa, who's got a seam and a spin for a first down to the 30. Jabril Johnson makes the tackle after 11 yards for Lau Ufasa.
Just a lead zone to the right side. Again, those big splits by Washington State offensive line. He's able to find a crease and pick up positive yards on first down and another first down.
Now DJ Alexander, who missed the first two games of the knee injury, is the injured player. They've had injury issues at linebacker all season. Alexander missed those first couple of games, and then Michael Doctor, the team captain, out for the year. Jabril Johnson has filled in for both of those guys. But still not very good depth at the linebacker position.
Yeah, and that depth is being tested, and it will again here. As Oregon State is playing a lot of five and six defensive backs.
They rush only three. Catch and throw, Bobby Ratliff. Second catch of the game, this one for six or seven. Guy that splits time with the freshman River Craycraft at that slot receiver role. They roll in some more receivers. Mike Leach uses consistently eight different wideouts in this air raid offense. His idea of balance, spreading it around to multiple receivers. Extra man comes out of the backfield wide open. It's Mason for a first down to the 15. Steven Nelson makes the stop, but a gain of eight to move the chains.
And you see Connor Halliday again. He surveys the field, doesn't like what he sees down the field, and gets it right away to his back, Marcus Mason.
And Halliday beginning the second half, much like he began the first half, in rhythm and on target.
And getting rid of the ball quickly.
Does on this play as well. Strong throw to the sideline for Maley. Boy, we've talked all about Mannion's arm strength. That's an NFL throw there for close to a first down.
Yeah, that's from the far hash. Anticipated the throw and put it right on the numbers. And you're going to see him again. Look, he knows what he wants. He sees it. And he anticipates that throw and puts it right where he needs it.
And it is enough for a first down to the JUCO transfer, Maley. First down and goal for the Cougars. Opening possession of the second half. In the flats in a hurry. Bartoloni chopped down inside the five. Tackle made by Ryan Murphy as Bartoloni gets his first catch of the night, second and goal.
Watch the time of this throw, the quick release right there, catch and pitch by Connor Halliday. Ryan Murphy closed on the football just as quickly. Looked like Bartoloni had some room to go there.
Pressure up the middle. Flag is down. Laufasa close to the end zone. It was likely a free play anyway. Signal given for a touchdown. Jeremiah Laufasa in for his sixth score of the season.
You're going to see Oregon State's going to bring two blitzers up the middle. They will seal it off right there.
The runner was down short of the goal line. Offside on the defense.
Well, somebody had a better look. And after touchdown was the initial signal, we get a great look here. I think that's the right call, marking him short. Great work by our camera crew.
Mason had that seam, though. Good job of that offensive line picking up that dog by the linebackers of Oregon State. You'll see him find the crease. There's Mason. He's got daylight, and that knee is down.
Half the distance to the goal. Repeat second down.
So they accept the penalty and nullify the run from Laufasa.
Yeah, that was Laufasa again with the ball.
And so instead of third down and goal from the 1 foot line, it'll be second down and goal from the two. One of the worst red zone teams in the country. Only 13 touchdowns and 23 trips coming in. Halliday to throw, looking wide side to the corner for Galvin, but it's incomplete and it's third down. This is where you struggle when you're a team that can't run the football.
Well, because you don't ask your lineman to do it all the time. You don't practice it, and so you get down those tight spaces. Everything tightens up. The coverage of the defense, they have less ground to defend. You've got to find a way to get that ball in the end zone. When you don't run the ball a lot, it's just hard to ask your offensive lineman to do it.
Only average 59 rushing yards a game. Only UConn averages less. Third down and goal, Washington State. Laufasa hurtling to the goal line. No signal yet. Oregon State signaling that the ball came out. Still no signal from the officials, but the Beavers seem to think it's white football. The officials getting together to decide what they've seen. And here's our call.
The ruling on the field is the ball was fumbled prior to going across the goal line. Oregon State recovered.
What a huge turnover, and Oregon State takes over at the one.
Oregon State had seven defenders in the box. They're going to blitz. And you'll see Lou Laufasa go airborne, trying to get in the end zone. That ball looks like it came out. You'll see him there going airborne, extending the football out.
I think he crossed the plane before
it's hard
the ball
to tell from
out.
That angle.
But it has to be indisputable video evidence to overturn the call on the field, which is fumble.
Boy, it looks like he crossed the plane.
And again, the ball only has to touch the front side of that white line.
Absolutely.
For it to be a touchdown.
What an effort by Lou Afasa. Again, you see him take off in the air. Boy, it looks like he crossed the plane.
Yeah.
That is the cross. That's clear right there. We'll see right here. Give us one more time. You'll see right there. Looks like the ball is in his possession. It crosses and breaks the plane of the end zone.
Fancy little toy you got over there.
Yeah, it's kind of nice, huh?
After further review, it was determined that the runner was not on the ground, stretched the ball over the goal line, touchdown.
Call reverse, extra point away from a tie game.
And Mike Riley, one of the nicest men in college football, can only smile. He knows that if they're going to overturn the call, it's got to be indisputable. Not much he can do to argue that. So the extra point from Andrew Ferney out of the hold of Apodaca ties the game at 17. Washington State scores on its opening possession of the second half to lock the score early in the third.
Yay, fellas.
Long day, Matt, right? Good one going there, good one finished there, and a good one going here as Washington State has tied the game on a Laufasa touchdown run. Heard about Manziel and Texas A&M winning that game with their great combo of Manziel and Evans. Got a great combo here as well. Mannion and Cooks, top quarterback, top receiver statistically in the nation. And they'll take over after this kick. Victor Bolden from a yard deep. Bolden bouncing to the sideline and won't make it back to the 20. So Oregon State will take control for its second possession of the half. A three and out forced by Washington State's defense on the first possession. Sean Mannion, more than 2,000 yards passing, 21 touchdowns. A second-year team captain. Nobody's ever been a three-time team captain at Oregon State. He's only a junior. And he's got 253 yards tonight, trying to join Keith Wenning. He's the only guys in FBS to have 300 in every game so far. A deep drop, a double clutch, and a completion to Cooks. 18 yards across the 35. Deion Buchanan with the coverage as he angled across the field. That's what they love to do with it.
Gonna fake the draw. Look, they're trying to isolate Brandon Cooks, and they're gonna get him on a deep crossing route again. He's gonna bend it in front of the defensive back. And nice, accurate throw by Sean Mannion from deep in the pocket.
Seventh catch of the night for Cooks, 59th of the season. Here comes Cooks on the sweep play. Got a block. And got close to another first down. That was Kevin Cummings supplying the block on the first run play of the game for Cooks. They're on the season, has carried it now 13 times for 80 yards.
You can tell that Oregon State's trying to find a way to get Cooks the football. Again, in space, on the run, a handoff in the run game.
Seven in the box now, eight in the box for second down and one. And Teron Ward getting a first down to the 49. Calafatone Pole with a stop.
Now that's an efficient run. May not be a big run, but it's enough. What you're looking for to convert and get a first down. Washington State, like you said, eight guys in the box, the offensive line. Gets enough movement to pick up the first down.
Box much lighter for this first down play. The blitz is picked up, giving Mannion time to throw. Incomplete. Boy, is Dacon Brown nearly with an interception once again. Just barely bounced in there.
See Daquan Brown, yeah, the ball clearly bounces. He's doing his best sell job, though.
Yeah.
A for effort, right?
You gotta like this kid, though, true freshman.
Boy, he's got some skills. His first start was against USC.
Help shut down Marquise Lee. Only 27 yards in that 10-7 win for Washington State. It was the other corner, DeMonte Horton, that supplied the only touchdown of that game for the Cougars. Play action on second and 10. Presser gets to Cooks, and down he goes. A Mannion sack by Cyrus Cohen. Third of the season for the junior out of Hawaii, and it's third and long.
You're going to see Cyrus Cohen isolated on the tight end, one-on-one. Off the left side of your screen right here, you're going to see him one-on-one with the tight end. And he's going to make a move, dip the shoulder, and turn the hoop and get the sack. Big play for Washington State.
Turn the hoop.
In the corner. Dip, bend.
Third and 16. Manning goes to Cummings. He'll try and run for the first down, but Washington State rallies. Horton combines with Carpenter to push him out a couple of yards short on a gain of 14. So fourth down and three in the punt team coming out for Oregon State.
And Washington State holds.
So two possessions and two punts for Mike Riley's team in the second half so far. Leon Brooks goes back to receive the Costal punt. And a bounce into the end zone. So only a net punt of 22 yards. Washington State could be good at the 20 when we come back. We'll also look at some of the festivities from Dad's Weekend here in Pullman. That looks fun. Dad's Weekend here at Washington State. One of the festivities the Physics and Astronomy Club puts on is the pumpkin drop. This is the ninth annual pumpkin drop this morning. They dropped those pumpkins from the Webster Physical Sciences Building, the tallest building on campus at 14 stories high. Of course, Galileo with a law of fall that he came up with, doing similar things, dropping, I don't think he dropped pumpkins, but dropping objects from Italy's Tower of Pisa.
This is a pumpkin queen.
Throw incomplete from Halliday, second down.
Well, that's kind of physics I understand.
Yeah. There's the pumpkin queen.
And what's left of a pumpkin right there.
So Washington State's defense forces back-to-back punts to begin the second half. Cougars took it down and scored on their opening possession of this half. And on second down and 10, a five-man rush leaves Gabe Marks open for a first down. Working against Steven Nelson for 13 yards. Marks has been quiet, but has a first down reception there.
Just impressive Connor Halliday's knowledge of the offense. Saw the matchup he wanted, the soft coverage outside. Accurate throw to Marks along the sideline. And quickly out of his hands.
Yep. That's been the case all day. Only one sack for each side in 70 pass plays. Christoph Williams got a block this time from the freshman Craycraft and got 12 for a first down to the 45.
And again, they have the numbers match that they're looking for outside. And you'll see Christoph Williams again right there. Only one defensive back, two offensive players. And there he's getting a good block by Craycraft.
The true freshman throwing that block for Williams. Here comes pressure. Picked up. Halliday zips one wide of his intended receiver. And man-to-man coverage with the pressure coming, and then sailed it wide of Williams, who is defended by Nelson. So second and 10. Fossa gets four, so third and six coming up for Washington State.
Washington State sees Oregon State in their dime defense. It means they have six defensive backs on the field. They trigger the run, And Laufasa not able to pick up much yards. Nice job that Oregon State defense of rallying to the football.
Oregon State defense, one of the best nationally on third down. Twist is picked up, floating it for Maley in stride. First down to the 12. Ball came out, but it's a catch and a gain of 48 yards against Rashad Reynolds.
Again, one-on-one coverage, and Connor Halliday, what great touch on the football. You'll see him. Vince Maley, one of the most highly recruited JUCO guys. He's got speed and big play ability. One to play one, and there he is making the catch. That ball had some air on it.
How about Maley? Coming into the game, four of his 11 catches went for touchdowns. Had two long ones last week against Cal. And as an explosive play to set up first down at the 12. Here's a fade for Williams, who couldn't find it. Maybe in the stadium light, sometimes you lose the ball up there. Defense from Nelson, and it's second down and 10.
Boy, you can tell Connor Halliday wanted that one. He threw it over the other shoulder. Williams looked inside, and he threw it to his outside shoulder. The ball was out quick once again. He saw the matchup he wanted, and he knew he was going to throw the ball up there.
You know, Williams, good size, 6'2", 215, 3 inches on Nelson, who was defending. Second down, they go to the ground for Mason. He's to the six. They make it a very manageable third down and four. Steven Christian with the tackle. Washington State not running it often, but it's been an effective part of the offense tonight.
Well, again, that time Washington State counts five guys in the box. They're going to try to run against that every time. Marcus Mason able to pick up positive yards.
He remains in the game for a big third and four. And they give it right back to him. He's short. So fourth down and about a yard coming up with Jabril Johnson making that tackle. Looking for, what do you think?
I didn't like Lisa. That Connor Halliday, he's looking at coach going, hey, I want to go for it. And they're going to do it. Feel good about the last two stops of their defense. Pin Oregon State deep in their own territory.
And the work out of the gun on fourth down and two. Halliday makes a check. It's a fade for Maley. Touchdown, Washington State! What strong hands by Maley.
Watch him go up and glove the ball with the defender all over him. Feet inbounds for the touchdown. Boy, Connor Halliday knew exactly what it was. He caught that snap and put the perfect amount of touch in that ball.
And on fourth down and two, of course, it's a fade that converts and puts Washington State back in front. Vince Maley with his fifth touchdown on 14 catches this season. And the Cougs are back in front.
ESPNU College Football Primetime, brought to you by the Discover It Card. It's a game changer. And Dr. Pepper, always one of a kind.
Back in Pullman, Washington, you're looking at the second largest refracting telescope in the state of Washington inside there. Original lens that was polished in 1887. The Jewett Observatory. Washington State back-to-back touchdowns on its first two possessions of the second half to take a one touchdown lead. And now the true freshman Victor Borden out of his own end zone, upended across the 15 as we look back at that fourth down and two completion for the score.
You know, Mike Leach has a lot of confidence in his quarterback Connor Halliday because he's going to call an audible on fourth and two. He gets the matchup he wants right there with Vince Maley, one-on-one in the corner. He's going to catch it and just put the right amount of touch on it where his guy can make a play on the ball. Fourth down. That's having confidence in your quarterback.
Holiday with a touchdown throw that has Washington State in front. His first touchdown pass of the game. His 14th of the season. Oregon State back to work. They start with a run to Storm Woods, who's got only a short gain. Oregon State still trying to get that running game going. Third worst nationally.
And you get the feeling that this young Washington State defense, that defensive line, they're starting to attack. And those linebackers, they're feeling confident after their first two stops to start the second half.
A cushion on Cooks to the near side. He goes in motion on second down. Pressure in the face of Mannion, who gets it off on a screen. And Woods makes the cut for a first down. Actually going to be close. Didn't get a very good spot as Justin Sagote made the tackle. It is enough. Oregon State moves the chains here on the third drive of the second half for the Beavers, looking for their first second half points.
And if they can't get the ball to Brandon Cooks, they're going to fake it to him right to set up the screen. Love the design of that. He attracts a lot of attention.
Nation's leading receiver. They get it to him on a bubble, but a poor throw is incomplete. Seen them run that about a half dozen times tonight with Mullaney out in front to block. This time Mannion misfires. The guy that injured his knee against Washington State last year missed two games because of it and then found himself in a controversy with Cody Vaz taking over the starting spot and excelling. There's a question as to who the starter would be entering camp. They didn't announce it until the week before the opener. But it's proven to be an excellent decision. He's turned into the nation's leading passer. On second down, play action. He's pressured. He steps out and heaves it out of bounds. Third down. Calipatone Pola is turning into a leader for this defensive line, applied the pressure.
That D line once again making Sean Mannion feel the pressure. Coming off the edge. Look at him attack. He's right up the middle in his face. Boy, and you think Sean Mannion wanted to take a shot one-on-one coverage to Cooks to the wide side of the field. Poley had a different idea.
They rush only four. Mannion loads up. Has a completion, first down. It's Caleb Smith, who's turned into the starting tight end with Connor Hamlet out of the game with an injury. And Smith gets a first down and a gain of 29.
You'll see Caleb Smith, he's just gonna go and cross the field this way. He's a big target at 6'6". And look at the protection holds up. And Sean Mannion just puts it right on him.
Big third down conversion for the Beavers. First down at the 41. All kinds of time. Zips one back to Smith. First down at the 21. Taylor Taliulu with the stop. And Sean Mannion over 300 yards once again.
And again, Caleb Smith open, getting a free release. Boy, that one looked a little close right there, yeah. Didn't it? Makes the catch.
Process rule.
Yeah.
That should be an incompletion based on the process. Got to complete the process of making the catch.
Over 300 yards once again.
Only Keith Wenning at Ball State has also had 300 yards in every game this year. So the play stands and they come back with a screen to the fourth tight end. This is Tyler Perry. Where they got a deep stable of those tight ends, a position that Mike Riley called beautiful. We talked to him earlier this week.
Yeah, it really fits in what they do in multiple tight end sets. And the strange thing about it, when you look at them, you think that mean that you also run the football well with all those tight ends, tight formations, but they really use it just to set up the pass because you have to respect the number of people they have on the line of scrimmage.
Second and a yard. They fake or give the Woods, and he gets a first down. So first and goal for Oregon State with this third quarter clock winding down.
Oregon State putting together a nice drive right here. They got to be able to finish it off with a touchdown, though. They've answered the challenge so far. Can they finish this drive off with a touchdown? Again, I have to keep an eye on those tight ends right now. Play action pass on first down. Look for Smith or Perry.
Throwing the slant, Cooks can't hang on. Put it right there. Might have heard footsteps coming from Dale Buchanan. And it's second down and goal.
Well, they got the matchup they wanted, one-on-one outside with three tight ends in the game. Boy, you don't see that very often. Brandon Cooks took his eye off the ball the last second.
Mike Riley's team, normally pretty good in the red zone. Tonight, four trips, only two touchdowns. Looking short side into a tight window. Woods had it knocked away. Tawna Pritchard was in coverage. Redshirt sophomore to Lakewood, Washington. Makes it third down and goal with an injured player. It's Daryl Monroe down for Washington State. Leader of this defense out of his middle linebacker spot. I want to remind you that tomorrow on ESPNU, coverage of women's college volleyball continues. UCF in Louisville, action in the American. It's 1 o'clock tomorrow on ESPNU between a couple of red-hot teams. UCF has won four straight. Louisville's won seven in a row after losing five straight earlier in the season. Monroe to his feet and off the field in his own power. Looks like maybe a shoulder.
Yeah, it looks like that left arm is hanging a little bit. Boy, they need him down here in the red zone. He's the guy that makes the calls and checks and gets them lined up against the various formations of Oregon State.
11 play of this drive.
Cooks isolated.
Mannion looking right at him. Double clutches, throws, end zone. Touchdown, Oregon State. Once again, Cooks was the decoy, and Kevin Cummings gets his second score of the year.
And you'll see right here as it begins to roll, the attention that Cooks is going to draw up here. Attract two defensive backs, and that leaves Cummings one-on-one. He gets inside position on the defensive back. Ball is on the money. Touchdown.
And we are tied once again. What a game this is turning into in Pullman. Cummings, the senior out of Culver City, California, in his first season in a starting role, as his second score to even the issue late in the third. And it came on a big third down for Oregon State, which it punted on its first two possessions of the half. This is a matchup of two of the top three quarterbacks in the country, and the guys in the offenses as a larger picture have been as advertised.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you look at the proficiency in which these two quarterbacks are throwing the football, getting it to different players too. You know, we talked about Mannion Cooks, the best duo in college football. Well, they've been using him as a decoy some, and the other receivers around him are benefiting from the attention that he draws.
Yeah, Mullaney leading the way, more than 100 yards receiving. Cooks on that touchdown drew a couple of defenders, and it opened up Kevin Cummings for the game-tying score here in the third. Ricky Galvin from a yard deep. Galvin gets a block and brings it out across the 25. So Washington State back to work. Second year of Mike Leach's air raid offense. Top 10 in the country throwing the ball. Behind this guy, Connor Halliday. We've seen time as a starter each of the last 3 years, but the undisputed starter for the first time this year.
Yeah, it's his first time as the guy.
Right.
And he has really taken off and shining here. We talk about his command of the football. He's been able to demonstrate that by getting rid of it so quickly.
On first down, Mason with a big hole. And he gets six. Defense collapsing, second down and four. Dylan Wynn over to make the stop from his defensive end position. And again, not running it often, but they've been effective when they have.
Well, they're just using a box count. They got to see five guys in the box. They're going to hand it off.
Scan of the field coming underneath. Ratliff couldn't hang on. That makes it third and four. Tyreek Zimmerman with the coverage. This Oregon State defense 2 weeks ago against Colorado State held them to a 2 of 15 on third down. Top 15 in the country on third down. It's been a staple under Mark Baker in his decade plus as the D coordinator. He shows pressure and brings it. And the slant is broken up. Nelson with the coverage on Isaiah Myers, and Oregon State forces the punt. So the blessing of the air raid attack is that you can move the ball quickly. But the curse is that there's drives like that where in the blink of an eye, you're giving it back.
That's right. You know, it doesn't take much time off the clock. Your defense is forced back onto the field. And you can see, even from their own 34-yard line, Connor Halliday is still going, aren't we going to go for it?
Yeah.
I'm not afraid to pull the trigger.
Cooks back to receive this one. It's a fake, but it's boxed. And Oregon State's going to have the ball at the 27-yard line. They tried to snap it to one of the up men. He either wasn't ready or couldn't hang on.
Oh, boy, it hit him right in the chest, bounced off his numbers. And that one backfires on Washington State.
So what do you think? Was it a fake or did he just get in the way?
We'll take another look at it there. Looks like it was a fake. I don't know. That was tough. That he wasn't even ready for it.
Right.
But I don't know. It looked like everyone was moving to the left anyways, and they weren't set up for a rugby punt. So I guess it was some kind of fake. But, boy, that's risky. This one come back to haunt you.
Yeah, in a game like this with two great, equally great offenses, you wonder what other phase of the game can determine it. Mannion, a deep drop to buy time, zipping one for Cummings, and he gets his hands under it for a first down. First and goal, Oregon State.
Pick another chunk play by Oregon State. Again, look at Mannion step in there and just throw a fastball. That ball's humming out. Deep in the middle. Cummings making the sliding catch.
It takes such deep drops, but he can because he's got a cannon. Through a three quarters in Pullman. Oregon State, Washington State. Two teams at the top of the Pac-12 North are locked as we go to the fourth.
ESPNU College Football Primetime is presented by New Raspberry 5-Hour Energy. Available for a limited time. Get yours now.
100th Rose Bowl coming up this year. Pasadena. Of course, both these teams have played in Rose Bowls, but it's been, I'm going to go back to 1965 to find the last time Oregon State played in one. Of course, Washington State played in one in 2003. But the 1965 Rose Bowl, a 34-7 loss to Michigan in front of 100,000 at the Rose Bowl. They also went 1957. Their only win in the Rose Bowl was in 1942, but it was in Durham, North Carolina at Duke, 1 month after Pearl Harbor. And they were afraid of an attack again on the West Coast, so moved that game as far away as they could on Duke's home field. Oregon State went in there and beat them. First down and goal, Beavers, to begin this fourth quarter. Cook's coming in motion and taking it to the short side with a cut and a touchdown. Oregon State jumps in front on the first play of the fourth quarter.
They've used him as a decoy, and this time he is the real deal. You see him make that cut. He's got space. He's got the speed. Touchdown, Oregon State.
The Beavers take advantage of what won't go down as a turnover, but a special teams mistake by the Cougars.
Yeah, absolutely. Turned it over downs deep in their own territory, Washington State does, and Oregon State capitalizes on that opportunity.
The extra point from Romaine puts Oregon State in front by seven in a back-and-forth game here at Pullman. Brandon Cooks, one of the captains of this offense as a junior, the focal point of the offense for the first time as an 8-yard rushing score. You know, a lot of those explosive plays and then that Brandon Cooks connection with Sean Mannion. How those things played out over the course of three quarters?
Well, you know, turnovers are one apiece, but really you look at the turnover on downs with the box fake punt, and that gives an extra possession to the Beavers. They take advantage of it. That's the difference in the game, and explosive plays.
Ricky Galvin from the corner with some room. And Galvin planted by Romaine, the kicker, his third tackle of this game. Washington State to begin at the 27.
Look at Romaine filling like a linebacker there. Boy, he's walking off the field, his chest sticking out, and he should be.
Did you happen to see on Monday Night Football the Falcons punter who was making several tackles and then just de-cleated a coach on the sideline? Went out of his way to deliver a forearm shiver.
Gotta like that. That was a big tackle.
So the Cougars back to work, down a touchdown. The start of this fourth quarter. Halliday throws for Mealy, and it's picked off. Rashad Reynolds with his fifth career interception, back to the 30. A return of 16 yards for Reynolds. There's a flag down. So fifth pick of his career, but the first this season for the senior out of California.
After the play, personal foul, late hit on Oregon State. That's a 15-yard penalty from the end of the play, first down.
So Beavers maintain the football, but a 15-yard penalty moves it back to the 45.
We'll see. You see Reynolds in his back pedal, and then just a bad throw by Connor Halliday right to Reynolds. Let's see if we can see the penalty coming up.
Oh,
wow, that's a shot. That's that one to be called every time. Dylan Wynn.
So Oregon State trying to take advantage like they just did after the box special teams play. Same play they scored on, different player. Victor Bolden, first down inside the 35. His second carry today. And Bolden's now totaled 27 yards on those two touches.
It takes help from all sides. You're going to see Tyler Anderson, number 33, throw the block. Right there on the edge, see him lead the way, make the block that gives Bolden the edge right there. Big play, Oregon State.
From the 31, Washington State brings pressure. Cooks has it on the screen, needs one block. Inside the 5, it's first down and goal. Dale Buchanan came back to get him after 30 yards.
Watch Brandon Cooks again. He's going to come back for the tunnel screen. Look at the big boys out in front. He knows exactly what to do. Trying to get him out of the way as he throws a block just short of the end zone. And that's Josh Andrews. Looks like he's down on the play.
Andrews and Phillip, the left tackle, the only two guys up front that have started all six games for Oregon State, as they've had to shift guys all over the place up front. Tonight, the fifth different starting lineup in six games up front.
And you'll see Andrews right here, the defensive back, like they always do. They're going to go low on the offensive lineman, and looks like he's going to take a shot right on his knee or leg.
You got to hate that, watching that as a former O lineman, right?
Yeah, that's why you got to come down and get him before he gets you.
Yeah. Next pass will be our
another night by Mannion. 414 yards. Boy, we knew we were going to come close to 100 passes. That's our pitch count. We're getting close.
Next one will be the 90th. Critical turnover setting up Oregon State. You've now got it first down and goal. It's Woods. Second effort gets him in. Touchdown, Oregon State. And Josh Mitchell, fresh into the game, provided the block to open that hole. Second rushing score tonight for Storm Woods, and the first two score lead for either side. Our man's extra point is good. And Oregon State has scored 21 points in its last seven plays to take a two touchdown lead.
Thank you.
They say no good deed goes unpunished. And some days it seems true. But we keep on doing the things that matter. Like buying new Raspberry 5-Hour Energy. From now to the end of the year, a portion of each sale benefits Living Beyond Breast Cancer to empower women affected by breast cancer. New Raspberry 5-Hour Energy. It's one good deed that will go just right.
Introducing the Rack Roll Down, the lowest prices ever at Rent-A-Center. We've rolled down prices on your favorite brands throughout the store. Everyone's pre-approved for our new lower prices, so hurry in and save like never before at Rent-A-Center.
ESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Back in Pullman, and now for tonight's game track, brought to you by Taco Bell. 21 unanswered for Oregon State to take a 38-24 lead. They've scored three touchdowns on their last seven plays. And Sean Mannion has gone over 400 yards passing with two scores.
Well, you know, they came out right after the half and got stopped twice in a row. But I tell you what, Danny Langsdorf, offensive coordinator for Oregon State's, really found a rhythm calling plays and getting the ball to different playmakers in their offense.
Good kick here from Romaine. Galvin will take a touchback. So Washington State begins the drive at the 25-yard line. We said when Washington State had it in the five trying to run the ball and didn't have success, that's a spot where this style of offense doesn't thrive, but down two scores should be a spot where it feels just fine.
Yeah, absolutely. They're going to continue to throw the ball. They're in a up-tempo mode anyways, and these types of teams have the ability to come back. That's why this Oregon State defense cannot let up right now. Got to continue to attack and play smart.
Catch and throw on the swing. It's Mason with a defense rally. Ball came out. They're jumping on top of it. John Fullington. Instead of a gain of two, it's a loss of four.
You're going to see right here, Mason's going to catch the swing pass, keep it going a little bit more. And when he catches the ball, watch what you're going to see. Freeze it right here. There are four white jerseys about to contain him and lay the hit to cause a fumble.
Three-man rush, collapses the pocket, and the throw sails over the head of Williams. Now third and 14. They're getting some pressure with just three guys.
Yeah, they're getting high rushes off the edge, forcing them to step up, and they're playing coverage in the back end. And like we showed you, they're rallying to the football. White jerseys attacking the ball in space.
Third down and 14. Halliday throwing the corner, picked off again. And it's Reynolds again, second interception in the last two possessions.
You'll see Reynolds at the top of your screen right there. He's just going to backpedal, and he's going to play the ball, look at the quarterback, and then drop off onto the second receiver, keep getting depth in this drop, and make a play on the football.
Reynolds, a guy that teams went after last year when the All-American Jordan Poyer was here, now with the Philadelphia Eagles. But Reynolds, a guy they've stayed away from this year for the most part. But they go after him on back-to-back drives, and he comes up with picks on both throws. So now Oregon State trying to put this one on ice. Up two scores and with the ball early in the fourth. Here comes Cooks in motion. And Cooks with a first down. Great blocking in front from Mulaney that time. Kellen Clute, the tight end, was out there as well. Multiple ways to get him involved.
Yeah, they're going to put him in motion right here this way. And look, they've already got the defense leveraged and outnumbered there. And they're going to get the ball to one of the fastest players on the field in Cooks at full speed. Look, he's got the edge with blockers in front of him.
Here comes Cooks again. A decoy. A screen. Woods able to slip through for four. Good tackle, Jared Byers, his first of the game. And it'll be second down.
That was big number 69, Josh Andrews, again out in front of that screen, picking off a defender, giving Woods just enough room to pick up a few yards.
So good to see Andrews back in the game after coming out for a play, which was a touchdown run on the previous possession.
Like you said, one of the two guys has not missed a snap or start this season. Long 24 starts in his career coming into this game.
Washington State tops in the Pac-12 in takeaways. Could use one here. Mannion firing. Cummings inside the five. It's first down and goal for Oregon State. On a completion of 20 yards to a guy that's had a really good second half in Cummings.
And watch as Sean Mannion takes this snap. Watch the protection the offensive line gives him. He's got a clean pocket. He's going to step up and drive the football to Cummings over the middle of the field wide open.
He's got his seventh catch of the night for 73 yards and a touchdown, which seems like forever ago. Tied the game at 24 late in the third. Here's Woods trying to find a seam. Planted by Cohen. The ball came out. And Destiny Files on the run. All the way back to the 33. Cyrus Cohen with a textbook tackle.
You want to show how to tackle? Drop your hips, wrap the arms, and finish the tackle.
But that's coming back.
Cyrus Cohen, yeah. Looks like it may come back. And again, it's Caleb Smith.
The ruling is under review.
That was a heck of a tackle right then. And Caleb Smith, the tight end number 10, lost his block off the edge. And you'll see Storm Woods. This is one you got to hit up inside and take what the defense is giving you. You can't run east and west and lose yardage for your team. Hopefully this is coming back for Oregon State.
And it very well should. The ground causes this. Wow, that is, in an age where defenses complain that there's no correct way to make a good tackle anymore, no legal way to do it, there's an example.
That was great. That was like a wrestling move.
Yeah, that was great. Sweet.
Takedown.
After review, the runner's elbow was down before the ball came out. And it's not a fumble. It'll be second down on the 8.5-yard line.
Oregon State dodges a bit of a bullet, has it second and goal, trying to extend the lead to three scores. Still early on in the fourth quarter. They trailed by a touchdown late in the third, but then scored three touchdowns in a seven-play span.
And Storm Woods will look back on that play and realize he should have planted his right foot and headed north and south to pick up three dirty yards. That's what the offense needed.
Still in a spot where the Cougars could desperately use a takeaway. Even a field goal makes it a three-score game. Pressure from the near side. Mannion steps into the throw. End zone touchdown, Brandon Cooks. Second score in a row for the nation's leading receiver. And Oregon State has scored 27 unanswered here in the second half.
I see Brandon Cooks in the back of the end zone. 2 feet down. That's a touchdown.
And a lot of the folks starting to file out of here. But Oregon State going up three scores in the blink of an eye. The last two off of interceptions from Rashawn Reynolds. Remember the one before that was off a botched fake punt. My, how this game has turned. Halliday picked off by Reynolds. That led to this touchdown from Woods. And then Halliday picked off by Reynolds once more. Second pick of the season, second pick of the quarter. And Brandon Cooks with his second score of the night. Mannion and Cooks with their 17th all-time hookup. And no doubt a school record that will be broken very soon. So that kick goes out of bounds, and it'll give the ball to Washington State at the 35.
Out of bounds against the kicking team.
Fourth touchdown
at the 35-yard line.
In the last 12 plays for Oregon State.
Look, watch what Oregon State does here. Sean Mannion's going to give a play-action fake right here. They're going to bring pressure off the edge, Washington State. And then you're going to see Cooks come here. The DB is going to peek in the backfield and lose track of the best player on the field for an easy touchdown.
Back-to-back scores for Cooks, who had a touchdown and a jet sweep play the previous possession. Halliday's been picked off twice in this fourth quarter. Keeps the play alive, heaves it downfield, and this is a third interception. This time it's Nelson. His fifth of the season, which leads the country. At five Washington State turnovers, your difference tonight.
And it's three interceptions in a row, the last three possessions. You'll see Connor Halliday again, forced from the pocket. Instead of throwing it away, he's going to throw it high and late towards the middle of the field. That's just a jump ball. And Steven Nelson's there for the INT.
We talked about explosive plays. You've had plenty of those. The Mannion Cooks connection, which we see right here. And then turnovers. Washington State protected it fairly well during the first half. But things have unraveled here in the fourth.
You know, the last touchdown to Cooks, too, it was eye discipline by the secondary of Washington State. Giving up a bunch of explosive plays in the last two games coming into this game tonight. 13 plays of 20-plus yards. And a lot of that has to do with discipline with your eyes, especially when you're bringing pressure.
They fake the Cooks and give the Ward. And he spins his way for a first down. Tough running from Teron Ward. The junior out of Concord, De La Salle, powerhouse in California from your neck of the woods.
Yeah, Northern California.
Got a few guys on this team out of De La Salle.
Yeah, they put out a lot of players. All the colleges know where De La Salle is. So the offensive line for Oregon State is really doing a heck of a job controlling the line of scrimmage right now in this fourth quarter when it matters.
Here's Cooks. Devontae Horton pulls him down, lost a yard. It'll be second down and 11. So Oregon State on the verge of moving to 3-0 in conference play, winning its fifth straight after losing the opener to FCS Eastern Washington. You had to figure that folks around Corvallis thought the sky was falling after they lost that opener. But Mike Riley righting the ship and his team with an impressive five-game run, assuming the score hangs on.
Yeah, especially coming off a 9-4 season last year to lose one to an FCS school. Not the only team that did that weekend, but certainly that shocked them.
They're one of seven FBS schools to lose to an FCS school. Here's Ward with the first down on a screen into Washington State territory. He got 15 before Buchanan dropped it.
The screen game has been very good to Oregon State here this afternoon. Good patience by Sean Mannion to let it develop below the offensive line. Getting downfield in front of Woods.
Draw play. They'd love to get this going moving forward. How about Teron Ward? Gets nine, so second and one. And so it'll be Oregon and Oregon State at 3-0, tied atop the Pac-12 North.
How about that, huh?
Those two teams will meet up, as always, final weekend of the season, the Civil War. That'll be in Eugene, November 30th.
I'll tell you what, and Oregon passed that Washington test this afternoon. Flying colors, they put so much pressure on you.
Ward bounces this time and slips a couple of tackles for a first down to the 30. Well, that game with Oregon, of course, the final weekend of the season, but between then for Oregon State, relatively easy one at Cal next weekend. But then they've got Stanford and USC at home back-to-back weeks, at Arizona State, Washington at home. Those are four straight games there that they might, USC, they'd be favored, but three of those four, there's a good chance they're the underdog.
Well, I'll tell you what, it's really interesting, too, because obviously an air raid passing attack right now, next week against Cal and Sonny Dykes, the same type of attack. Then they'll have to shift total gears again, once again, against Stanford and USC in a more pro-style offenses. So it'll be interesting to see how they do it. In their last two games, mobile quarterbacks come up, Washington and Arizona State. So it'll be interesting to see how their schedule goes. But at this point in the game, this is where this offense has advantage. They get into their 4-minute mode. They start grinding away. And this is building confidence for this offensive line and this run game that they knew they had to get going here. And it's a great start to here tonight. Confidence in the offensive line. They're healthy again. Storm Woods is back. And they get that running game going with Mannion's ability to push the ball vertically down the field to guys like Cooks and Mullaney. And this is an explosive offense, even more explosive. They're averaging over 40 points a game coming in. So the sky's the limit here for this Oregon State offense.
Yeah, averaging 41 and a half, which is top 20 in the country. 41 and a half points a game is only fourth in the Pac-12. Here's Cooks getting loose for his third touchdown of the fourth quarter. This one from 30 yards, that breaks the school record for connections between one quarterback and one receiver. And Mike Riley, with a big smile on his face, greets a guy that he speaks very highly of. He says, Brandon Cooks, one of those kids you want in your program, always has a smile on his face. Team captain as a junior, along with that guy, Sean Mannion. And Oregon State with 35 straight points in about a 10-minute span here late in the game. Cooks now 11 catches for 137 and two scores. They punted. Horton bit. Lofted it over the top. Oregon State potentially one of the beneficiaries of shakeup Saturday, with Stanford going down to Utah. Shaking up the Pac-12 as Galvin gets shut down at the 20. Oh, we got volleyball in some parts of the country later today. 1 o'clock Eastern on Sunday between a couple of hot programs. UCF has won 4 in a row. Louisville's won 5 straight. Or has won 7 straight after losing 5 in a row. 1 o'clock Sunday on ESPNU. What was a sellout is now a little bit light crowd as Austin Apodaca comes into the game for the first time. Redshirt freshman that they like a lot.
Out of Longmont, Colorado.
And he starts with a completion to his classmate, River Craycraft. First down to the 33. Apodaca in for Connor Halliday, who threw 3 interceptions on his last 4 throws. After a really pretty impressive first 3-plus quarters of this game.
Apodaca is a redshirt freshman that this coaching staff is very high on. He's an athlete back there at the position that can sling the football.
Maufasa with a good surge over the right side of the line for 7. Apodaca came in during the Stanford game when Halliday went out with the injury. 18 of 26 for 165 yards and a couple of touchdowns. Back to Maufasa, first down. Up to the 48. So Washington State will fall to 4-3. Still already more wins than they had in Mike Leach's first year. And regardless of what happened here in the fourth, he's got this thing turned around, headed in the right direction.
Yeah, you think what they've been able to do and what Mike Leach has done wherever he's been, that's win football games. You know, last year starting and playing 17 freshmen last year, still a very young football team, improving every week. This is a big game for them, too. The winner of this game takes a big step forward to becoming bowl eligible.
Oregon State will get to within a win of bowl eligibility. Washington State hasn't been to a bowl since 2003.
That's amazing. You think of all the players that come out of this program. Been down for a while, though. And that's why Mike Leach was brought in. He's won everywhere he's been.
Apodaca, quick release. Bartoloni fumbles, and it's scooped up, and it'll be returned all the way back inside the 20 by Caleb Solo. What a disastrous fourth quarter for Washington State, which unfortunately for them, perception-wise around the country, folks that didn't see this game aren't going to realize what the first three quarters were like.
Yeah, it was tightly contested. You see right there, and turnovers have been real story of this football game, and what's really turned it into a rout here in the fourth quarter. And a fumble, that is four straight possessions with the turnover for Washington State.
Three times, Rashawn Reynolds having a hand in it. Back-to-back picks for him, and then he forced the fumble on that play. Just ripped it right out of the hands of Bartoloni. And now Cody Vaz will come into the game for Oregon State, a guy that was a starter for a chunk of last season, made four starts after Mannion's injury. And he hands off to Chris Brown, redshirt freshman from Fresno, California, who's more of a quick twitch guy. You've got Woods and Ward, who are more compact banger backs inside. Brown gives him a little bit different of a dimension as he's in there with Vaz.
5'10", 198 pounds. Let's take a look at Cody Vaz. Guy's played, like you said, some snaps and some starts for Oregon State. Tightly contested battle coming in through the spring.
Threw for 1,511 touchdowns last year after the Mannion injury. We'll get a chance to throw it here. And getting close to a first down is Mitch Singler.
Mitch Singler doing the right thing and making sure he stayed in bounds.
Boy, this is a 24-17 Washington State lead late in the third quarter.
That's what turnovers do. The fake punt really started it all. You know, that's, you go to count that, that's five turnovers. Giving the ball up on downs and the botched fake.
Vaz throwing a slant that's intercepted. And Horton flips it off. DeMonte Horton with his fourth interception of the season. And then it was Tanner Pritchard that ran it out to the 15.
Horton's just going to take this away from the receiver on the slant at the top of your screen. Quick slant. That ball is in there. Horton just takes it away from the receiver and then pitches it to his buddy.
Why not?
Why not?
At this point. Washington State, which had a touchdown lead late in the third, has turned it over four times in this fourth quarter. Laufasa up the middle on first down for six. Yeah, 2003, they beat Texas in the Holiday Bowl December of 2003. You go back to January 1st of 2003. That's her last trip to the Rose Bowl.
Well, you see the things that Mike Leach has done in terms of recruiting the youth on this roster, the facility upgrades that they're doing here at Washington State.
Yeah, the new football operations building in the end zone to our left from our booth view to be completed late next spring. $61 million building. That's part of a $130 million total renovation to the stadium that includes this new press box, new sound system, new video board.
Yeah, what a great setting this is for football. With the completion of that center. State of the art.
Diamond in the rough, Pullman, Washington.
Yeah, absolutely. Great little college town. Out in the country. People love their Cougs.
Craycraft has it for a first down. Now, we didn't get to stay in Pullman. We stayed down in Lewiston, Idaho, which is about a 40-minute drive. But coming through Pullman this afternoon, you're right, really small, but really nice-looking college town. Traditional-looking college campus.
A great time of year to be here, too, with the colors changing. Apodaca misfires with a wide open Galvin.
Yeah, he knew he missed that one. Boy, he wanted it too. And that's what Mike Leach was talking about, his young football team. Need to constantly be improving. A great reminder here again about how important it is to take care of the football.
Apodaca takes off. Boy, Ricky Galvin came back and tried to deliver a huge block, but fanned on it. Boy, what a wild day of college football was. It all started with Missouri upsetting Georgia, Texas routing Oklahoma.
Mac Brown.
Does it save his
Pulling
job?
It off. Greg Robinson, defensive coordinator, putting it on him.
Michigan gets beat at Penn State in four overtimes. And then Utah knocking off Stanford in Salt Lake City. We'll have the details of those stories later.